Hey, what is up everyone? Norman from Future Studio University here. Welcome to the second video in our retrofit series. As always, before we get started, you should know that you can find all the content as tutorials and all the code snippets for easy copy and pasting on our website. The link is the first thing in the description below. All right, let's get started. In the first video in the series, we've learned what retrofit is and how you can use it to request data from the server. We have used retrofit to access and display all GitHub repositories of a user. Now, if you haven't seen that video yet, you should watch it right now since it will make it easier for you to understand the rest of this video. In this video, we will turn things around and send data to the server. In just a few minutes, you will know how you can send Java object as your request body. Before we start in RetStudio, let's quickly review get, post, and put requests. We haven't talked about it in this series yet, but generally, if you're requesting data from a server, you're doing a GET request. That's what we have done last video when we displayed the open source repositories. Now, in this video, we want to send data to the server. This is usually done in a POST or PUT request. A POST request is if you're trying to add a new data item. For example, if you're sending a user object, that means the server creates a new account. On the other hand, a PUT request updates an existing data item. In the user example, this would be a profile update. It doesn't create a new user, it simply changes an existing one. I know you're anxious to start in RetStudio, so what's the plan? Today we will implement an app view, which lets the user create a new account. Thus, we're sending a new user object as a post request to the server. I've already prepared a view and the basic retrofit setup. What we need to do now is to describe the endpoint we want to talk to. So let's check what the API developer gave us. The API developer gave us an example request in Postman, which is a pretty decent tool to test REST requests. As you can see, the request body should contain the name and email as strings, the age as an integer value, and topics is an array of strings of topics the user is interested in. Now, additionally, we know that the URL is under /API/user. Also, we see back here that we need to send a post request. Now, this is everything we know to describe our endpoint in retrofit. If we execute this, we will also see that we are getting the exact user object back plus an ID. All right, now we need to describe that endpoint we have just seen as a retrofit endpoint. We're creating a new account, so let's name the endpoint create account. We're creating a new account with a user object, so let's pass a user object. And we're also getting a user object back. Depending on the context, you might want to use different classes for responses and requests, but in this case, it's almost the same, so we're just gonna use the same class. As always, in retrofit, you have to wrap it in a call class. Next, we need to annotate it with additional information. First, we know this is a post request, so let's add the post annotation. The final piece is to declare the user object as a request body. This is simply done by adding a body annotation right here. Retrofit will now create a request body out of the passed user object. And that's all we have to do here. So next, we have to describe the user object. As we know from our Postman request, we have four properties here. We have a string name, we have a string email, we have a integer of age, and we have a string array of topics the user is interested in. Now let's make them all private. Additionally, when we are getting the user back, we will get an integer. Now since it is nullable, I'm going to use the integer class for that one. Finally, let's add a constructor. Without the ID, since when we're passing it to the server, we don't have an ID yet. And let's get a getter for the ID so we can display if everything was successful. All right, that should be our user class. I've jumped into the main activity. I've already prepared the boring view stuff and also the basics of retrofit. Once the user clicks on the Create Account button, we we need to read in these properties, create a user object, and then send it to the server. So let's do that. We have a new user object. We can use a constructor we have just created and pass the name. Pass the email. We can pass the age, which is an integer, so we have to do a little transformation. Ah, damn it. Finally, we have to send the topics, which wasn't a string array, but we only have one edit text, so we're just gonna split it after every comma. So let's do topics, get text to string, and then let's split it at every comma. All right, we have our user object. Now we need to send that to the server. So we're just gonna pass this here, and let's jump in here. I've already prepared a client for a user API, so what we now need to do is get a call object for our request. And we can do that by simply calling client. And there's our new method, and we can pass the user object we just read in from the input. We're getting back a call object. Since we're working asynchronously, we're going to use enqueue, and we're going to pass a callback. Now, if something went wrong, I'm just going to do a little toast. If everything worked out, I'm also going to display a toast and display the user ID. We know when we get the user object back from the server, it has a user ID. Now, as you know from the last video, you can access the server response via response.body. And since we declared a getID method, we can use that here. Finally, we're executing the request. So let's see what the server receives and everything works out. All right, let's add some example input. All right, yeah, we got a user ID back. Yippee. Okay, if we would send all of this as a put request, for example, if the user updates his account, we would simply change the input declaration. So if we go back to user client and change this to a put request, that's everything we have to do. Alternatively, we could create a second endpoint here if you need both methods, creating an account and updating the profile. A nice thing about retrofit, which I haven't said yet, is if a object property is null, retrofit will just ignore it. So in our user class, the ID is null when we are sending it to the server. And since it is null, retrofit will not even create a JSON property for it, it will just ignore it. Let's review what we have learned in this video. You have seen the difference between get, post, and put requests in action. You've also learned how to send Java object as a request body to the server. Thanks for watching. We really appreciate you being here. Please like the video if you learned something, and subscribe if you want to see more videos in this series. Make it rock and enjoy coding.